Apex Legends is the newest, hottest battle royale game inspired by popular games like the class-based Overwatch and the first big battle royale games, PUBG. Apex Legends is a 60-person, 3-man squad class-based battle royale FPS, and this new game is being praised as one of the most stable battle royales on the market. And the best part? The game is totally free to play. However, as with any new game, there have been a number of reported bugs and issues that players are experiencing while playing this new game. From FPS drops, muted audio, to complete game crashes, the subreddit for Apex Legends has daily complaints that select users can't play this game that everyone's excited over. So if you're trying to fix your install of Apex Legends, or maybe you've never even played and you want to get started, here's the ultimate guide to installing and optimizing Apex Legends on your Windows PC. If you've never played Apex Legends before, you'll need to download the Origin installer. Most modern EA games require you to download and run the games through the Origin client on your Windows PC, so Apex Legends does need to be run through Origin. If you don't have an account, you'll need to sign up, or if you do, you can just sign in, and then download the client to your computer. Once you've downloaded the client, you'll need to sign in again, and then you're going to want to install Apex Legends. Already installed it, you're going to want to update it to the newest version. That way you can play online. The entire download is approximately 13 gigabytes, which is pretty big if you have a slow connection. So you may need to wait a few hours before it's fully installed. You've already installed it and you've played it and you're suffering from any sort of issues in the game, including low FPS, crashing, the audio being muted, or there being a weird audio delay, it could be a symptom of an outdated driver. So we're going to look through some of those issues and see how we can fix them. If you have an Nvidia graphics card, you can open your Nvidia control panel, go to Manage 3D Settings, and find Apex Legends, and change some of their settings to make it so the game doesn't crash. If you don't see it in the drop-down list, you can click the Add button next to it, scroll through all of the applications on your computer, find Apex Legends, and add it to the list of preferred games. What this allows you to do is change select settings for your Nvidia card to provide yourself with the best gaming experience possible. Once you've added Apex Legends to the list, you can scroll down and look at your power management settings and change it to prefer maximum power. You can also change your pre-rendered frames to 1, but it will make the game lag just a tiny, tiny bit, which in any battle royale game can mean the difference between life and death. Done making these changes, you can apply them and then close out of the Nvidia control panel. In the description of this video, you'll find a text version of this guide that details the different specs that you need for your computer to run Apex Legends. Make sure that your computer is up to date with these standards before trying to run the game. Also, make sure that when you first launch Apex Legends that you've allowed your firewall to access the game. If it can't, you might experience some negative connectivity issues. If you're running Apex Legends on an old AMD processor, EA has already confirmed that the game can't even run on them, so it won't load. So if you're running something like an AMD Phenom, you're going to need to upgrade to a newer processor and likely a new motherboard before playing the game. Unfortunately, there's no fix available at this time. If you're running Apex Legends on a GeForce graphics card, several users have reported that the 2080 Ti, the current highest performing PC Nvidia card, won't even launch the game, which appears to be a driver problem. In order to play the game, you may need to roll back the driver to an older version. We have a guide on our website on how to do this. If you're already in the game and you're noticing that there's some performance issues, here are the suggested video settings that we think that you should use to be able to launch the game at maximum FPS. You're going to want to make sure that the game is in full screen, that you've disabled the VSync, that you sent your anti-aliasing to disabled or TSAA, which is a slight performance difference. Keep your native resolution to your monitor. Keep your field of view between 80 and 100. Use your texture streaming budget at high. Texture filtering as low as possible while still being playable. Ambient occlusion as low as possible. Shadow to low or lowest. Model detail should be low. Your effects detail should be low. Impact marks disabled and ragdolls low. Once you're done, you can apply your settings. You can make sure that other applications aren't placing overlays, like Discord, GeForce, or Xbox Gaming. You can clean your temporary files and uninstall other games to give your PC a little bit more room to have the game run. Try not to use products like CCleaner, as they may remove necessary files from your computer, and make sure you close out of Chrome when you're playing the game. Or you can follow our guide on optimizing Chrome performance to try to give yourself a little bit more RAM to play with. If you're having audio issues with Apex Legends, the first thing you're going to want to do is make sure that your Windows computer has the right playback device selected. You're going to want to make sure that your motherboard drivers, your sound card drivers, and your USB sound device drivers are all up to date. If you're having a problem updating your sound or video card drivers, the easiest way to do this is to download and install driver support. Driver support automatically updates all of the drivers on your computer without you even having to click, optimizes them for your computer's performance, and makes sure that you never miss a new game drop. So whether you're a casual, competitive player, or even a Twitch.tv streamer, you're going to want to make sure that all of your devices have the most up-to-date drivers and your computer is getting the most performance it possibly can. To download and install driver support, head over to driversupport.com where you can read this guide and other guides in our knowledge base.